Welcome to Boomsday 2012, the largest Labor Day fireworks celebration in the nation. Boomsday is brought to you by City View at Riverwalk. It's here, it's home, it's City View, the city of Knoxville. Visit Knoxville, it's all here, just for you. Enjoy. Dodge, cars you actually want to drive. Chrysler, imported from Detroit. Star 102.1, your number one hit music station. Q93, today's continuous country music. Hot 104.5, the beat of Knoxville. JFG Coffee, the best part of the meal since 1919. The Knoxville New Sentinel. And your Boomsday station. WBIR, straight from the heart. And now, live from City View at Riverwalk, Robin Wilhoit and John Becker.
Good evening and welcome from the south side of the river to the 25th annual Boomsday here in Knoxville, along with my colleague Robin Wilhoit. I'm John Becker. We hope you have a comfortable seat and are set to see some great fireworks.
That's right. I always like to say this. We have one of the best seats in the house.
No
Trust
question.
Me, those fireworks, 20,000 of them will be going off in just minutes right behind us. But Boomsday truly has been a day-long event for a lot of folks. About 1 o'clock today, folks started converging on Neyland Drive for a lot of food, a lot of fun, and of course the grand finale tonight, the fireworks, which are set to start less than 30 minutes now. 25 years just for Boomsday, of course. But then you consider they go all over the country, the world for that matter, putting on some of the biggest shows, most notably the 4th of July fireworks show in the nation's capital. They even go down to Guantanamo Bay, to the naval base there, or to the base there, the military base, and provide fireworks there as well. So they are known throughout the country, the world even, for their great pyrotechnic show. And of course, I know we're not going to be disappointed tonight. We never are disappointed when it comes to Boomsday.
Absolutely not. One of the biggest shows in the Southeast, with some 400,000 people expected this year on this side as well as the other side of the river. We are at City View on the Riverwalk, and what a great piece of property this is to bring you this show. We're going to bring you much more when we come back from a short break. And welcome back again from the south side of the river, a new spot for us. We'll talk much more about that. I'm John Becker along with Robin Wilhoit, set to bring you the 25th annual Boomsday.
You know, this is a big event for this entire city, but one person in particular. We're talking about Mayor Madeline Rojero of this great city of Knoxville. This is her first Boomsday as mayor, and she had this to say when we talked to her a little earlier this week.
Well, this is my first Boomsday as mayor of Knoxville, and I think it's great that this is not only the largest Labor Day fireworks event in the nation, it's also the best. And it's fabulous that so many people from our city and from the region comes together for this wonderful celebration. It also has a great economic impact when you get over 400,000 people down here. I think, first of all, it's wonderful that Boomsday is held in conjunction with Labor Day. It's one of my favorite holidays because it recognizes the contributions of our workforce, the men and women who toil every day to make our businesses prosperous and to strengthen our economy. So here's a great way because people from all walks of life come down here to take a day off of work and to celebrate our community, our region, and Boomsday. The other great thing about that is that here we have the greatest fireworks show in the country with the backdrop of such natural beauty. We have the river, we have the urban wilderness as a backdrop. So it's really a very special time for us in Knoxville. Well, I love all parts of Boomsday, but probably the sense of community, so many people coming together. And of course, the fireworks show was fabulous. The JFG sign is important to not only South Knoxville, but to all of Knoxville. It is an historic landmark. It's something that when you crossed the river, you knew you were coming home if you lived in South Knoxville. And I think it's important as a community that we preserve some of these significant landmarks. And later tonight, the switch will be flipped and turn on the sign for all of Knoxville to enjoy.
And we are back here live at City View on Riverwalk, where in just a matter of minutes, thousands, 20,000 fireworks will light the night sky. But you heard the mayor talking about the lighting of the JFG sign. Apparently, it was supposed to be lit just right before the show started.
And we're going to hear much more about that. Again, we want to check in with Moira Kay, who's standing by at the City County Building. Moira, what can you tell us?
John and Robin, it's so exciting as someone who grew up in East Tennessee to see this South Knoxville landmark brought back to its former glory. It's beautiful, and we want to show you how it happened.
We would like to welcome the landmark back to the Knoxville skyline as it will once again light up South Knoxville. Join me in re-illuminating the JFG sign. Here we go.
So gorgeous, as you saw in the video, such an exciting time for us here in Knoxville. And I've got with me Christy and Jeff. And Christy, first of all, you are with Riley Foods, and tell us a little bit about your all's part in this sign lighting.
Well, actually, Riley Foods is just really happy to be a part of relaunching the JFG sign. As you know, it's been down for about 2 years, so we're really just happy to have it reinstated and be a part of the Knoxville sign, the Knoxville skyline once again.
It's absolutely stunning. Tell us about the work that and effort it took to bring this sign back.
It's been extremely arduous process. We started 2 years ago, took the sign down, kind of lost the spot we were going to put the sign back up. So we worked with Knoxville Visit, the city, the Corbella Shriners, and a lot of other folks to find a place for the sign, get it put back up and relit and be part of Boomsday, especially the 25th anniversary.
And there's a lot of original sign, but there are some new features as well. Tell us about those.
There are. We changed the bulbs to LED bulbs. There's 852 of them, and it saves a lot of money on the electrical costs. And most of the sign is still intact with a lot of paint, refurbishment, and a lot of extra care to make sure we get it back up, and it came back on.
And it sure did. And thanks a lot, and congratulations on a successful launch of the sign.
Thank you.
Relaunch. Guys, have a great evening. All right, Robin and John, as you can tell, it did start to rain here at my vantage point at City County Building, but it's gorgeous down there, and the crowd does not seem to be deterred. Back to you.
Moira, thanks so much. We're hoping it's a quick shower. We've seen them throughout the day. We're counting on it to move through quickly. We do see some high clouds where we are, but hopefully that rain will clear off by showtime.
What always amazes me, though, despite the rain, folks still flood down here for the big show. Just as the JFG sign is a tradition for Knoxville, this event, Boomsday, is a tremendous tradition, 25 years strong, and it's amazing the number of people it takes to really put this show on and share it with the whole region.
The group that's a big part of that is called Visit Knoxville. We're going to hear from Kim Bumpus, its president.
Well, Boomsday is a tradition, so that's why it's important to Knoxville. And this year is our 25th anniversary, so we're very excited about it. We'll be firing it off of the railroad bridge this year, and that will be very representative of last year, but we've got a few surprises, so we're excited about it, and we're excited for everyone to come out. Boomsday impacts all of this community because it's 500,000 people that are coming from all over to Knoxville, Tennessee, and they get to experience what we have as a community as well as see a great fireworks display. But it's just an important event from a media perspective, regionally, nationally, to just right down to the day of. It is a year-long undertaking. I mean, it takes a team of people working on this, you know, here and there, year-round. You know, we have to go out and talk to our partners and get them on board to be a part of the festivities, as well as use it in our media pitches for regional and national publications, getting all the way down to the day of the event, which we really go into about a 30-day lockdown of running through this sequence, making sure it's right, and then we're here, you know, pretty much that entire weekend. This weekend, or this year, will be a little different as it relates to the festivities because we don't have a football game here home that weekend. We will be firing off the railroad bridge, and that's with a great partnership with Norfolk Southern, who's been great to work with. But we load all of the fireworks onto a train and then move them out onto the bridge. And that's where it's kind of a neat thing, because this literally could be said to be the world's largest fireworks show in the world off the back of a train. So that's exciting. But I think that what we have benefited from is just the fact that we were able to provide the same caliber of show to our community off of the railroad bridge, considering the other bridge was under construction.
And that was Ken Bumpus, president of Visit Knoxville. We are once again live at City View at Riverwalk. Talk about an area of town, a part of town that is really undergoing some transformation from the Henley Bridge, which is the construction still going on, to a number of things going on the south side. And as I mentioned, being here at City View, this is a new addition, not too old, to this south side. Dwight Price from City View at Riverwalk is here. Dwight, thanks so much for being with
us. Absolutely. Glad to be here.
This is a lovely place. Tell us about this part of town. We see it a lot. You want folks to come over here and visit it.
Absolutely. And we have lots of people in the building tonight as guests, just seeing City View for the first time. We just went on the market, the real estate market here about a month ago. I'm the listing agent for 120 condos here, 1, 2, and 3 bedroom. Beautiful views of the city, water taxi service back to the other side. And of course, when the Henley Bridge opens, we'll have the protected covered sidewalk back across so you can walk to downtown. So we're just excited about this project as part of the South Knoxville waterfront.
One of the first pieces of development that has really blossomed on the South waterfront in this renewed effort to get more development in this part of the city. You mentioned those water taxis. People might be concerned given the way the bridge looks right now and getting in and getting back to work in and out. Explain how that will work.
Well, the water taxi service has committed to working with us on weekends only right now. So you can easily get to the games, you can get over to the restaurants and the other marina on the weekends. We're hoping that'll be a full-time thing as more people live in the building. The building's capable of holding 125 families, so when we're fully sold out, we think that will be a regular service. We have people who live in the building now who walk to BB&T to work, who walk to Market Square. It is a nice leisurely walk if you're a walker. But some people do need the taxi service.
And you have access on the south side to many of the trails and this Riverwalk that are also looking to expand.
Absolutely. And when this whole project is completed, plenty of walking areas, park areas that you can access from right here.
All right. Dwight Price from City View at Riverwalk, thanks so much, and thanks for letting us enjoy
thanks
your beautiful digs.
Your event here tonight. It's a perfect place to watch the fireworks.
We're looking forward to it. This is I can't imagine this ideal deck. We're looking forward
you
to
bet.
This.
Front
time.
Stage. Center stage.
Absolutely. We are
yes.
Center stage. Foxy behind the camera for us. We have 5 cameras throughout the city. We hope you stick with us. We'll be back momentarily and get those fireworks going very quickly. From the south side of the river, we've got it covered. 5 cameras, Moira's location, and we are basically 10 minutes or so away. Michael Walden with Pyro Shows. These are the guys who impress us every year with their display. 25 years, and what's in store this year?
You know, this is the 25th anniversary, so we went back and we put all the staples that everybody expects. We do have some little twists. We're kind of doing a little twist with the waterfall tonight. It's going to be a little bit different, trying to surprise people a little bit. We've also brought back the old Jaws theme with the nauticals in the water. Mm-hmm. We used to keep that the secret, but it's not. We've added a twist to that. So we've added a few things new, but we're sticking with the staples of Boomsday.
Something else that's new, actually you did it last year, but you guys are firing from the railroad bridge over here. How much of a challenge is that, having to accommodate the construction that's going on as far as putting on the show?
You know, it literally takes almost twice as long to set up on a train than it does on the Henley Street Bridge. And other than the time and just being really careful and making sure everything's in exactly the right place, it's been really interesting, and it's a challenge that we've loved. Norfolk Southern's been great. All the people at the city of Knoxville and the fire department's been great. And there's not many places in the country that you can make something like this happen.
Last year, we did see some fireworks at the end of the show, a fire that some folks weren't expecting. Some were. We saw the fire department help out. Tell us about that and if we'll see the same thing this year.
I don't expect you to see the same thing. We've taken some extra precautions through the fire department and used some flame retardant material that we've not used in the past. Last year was kind of a fluke, and it actually turns out that after much investigation, it was probably a product malfunction, and you just change that stuff out and do everything you can to make stuff like that not happen. But the good thing is the bridge wasn't in danger, and no one was in danger, and everybody did their jobs properly, and we were in good shape.
And I'm sorry, real quickly, because I know time is wrapping up, but just how excited are you to perform in front of the hometown crowd?
We're always very excited. This is our homecoming. This is our big game, if you're using the football analogy, since it's football season, and we're all pumped and excited and really proud to be here.
All right. Mike Walden from Pyro Shows, thanks so much for all you guys do.
Yeah, thank you.
Absolutely.
And stay with us. We're coming right back with Boomsday 2012.
And we are minutes away from Boomsday 2012, the 25th year of Boomsday here in Knoxville. The good news, Robin, the rain has stopped.
And that is great news, in fact. You know what? Boomsday, 25 years old. We like to look back in time. So we decided to check out our archives, and this is Boomsday from 1988. Check it out.
It looked like the 4th of July on the Henley Street Bridge tonight as these people took part in what was billed the biggest Labor Day party in the history of East Tennessee, Boomsday 1988.
Oh, I think this is great. This is the best thing that Knoxville has ever had. It really is. It's a family thing, and it's just great.
It's enjoyable, and it's a great family outing. And I really think that Knoxville needs more holiday events just like this one.
It joins the community together, I think, really does. Helps form a bond in the people in the community.
Thousands of people lined Knoxville's waterfront to get a prime view of a fireworks celebration many here say they'll never forget. There was plenty of entertainment, including music and food, for the entire family.
Now get this, $60,000 worth of fireworks were used to light up Knoxville skies. That's more than 3 tons of explosives.
Although the show lasted only 20 minutes, this display was entirely choreographed and set to music.
It's been worked on the last couple of months. First they put together a musical soundtrack, then we sit down and try to figure what shells would look good with certain songs.
Workers worked around the clock to put on this high-tech Boomsday Festival. In order to accommodate this display, the Henley Street Bridge had to be closed for 53 hours. That caused headaches for some motorists.
It's a little aggravating. We were just coming in from the lake and it makes it a little inconvenient.
Organizers were pleased with this fired up crowd and they hope next year's Boomsday Festival draws an even bigger crowd.
10 seconds.
And Kim Hanser from Star 102.1 joins me now. And Kim, you've been to a lot of these Boomsdays, and the station's certainly been along for the ride.
Well, from the whole time. And it's interesting that that story was about the second year of Boomsday, 1988, because that's the year that almost didn't happen. The first year of Boomsday, there were a handful of people. Nobody really knew what to expect. And it's hard to believe that an event that has hundreds of thousands of people that come every year almost didn't happen that second year. But the city told U102 at the time, which was the name of the radio station, no, we want to get behind this. We want to do this, and so we kept chugging along, and we still have people at the stations in the Journal Broadcast Group that were here for those first Boomsdays.
It's amazing the way it's grown. Tell me a little bit about what your favorite parts are that you've seen become part of this celebration over the years.
Well, like everybody, the waterfall is everybody's favorite, and this year everybody's like, well, is it going to happen? Because, you know, we had the little fire incident last year, and everybody's thinking, oh, the waterfall's not going to happen, but the city officials assure me it is going to happen, and there's going to be all sorts of new things, because this being the 25th year, there's going to be some surprises. But there's going to be some of the old favorites that everybody expects as well.
And when you see the number of people, you know, the weather, we've had a few showers move through, honestly, but I mean, the numbers don't seem to be too affected by any of this.
No, and that's the thing. It's hard to believe that they almost canceled the second year and this wouldn't have happened at all. And now hundreds of thousands of people come in the rain, the wind, everything that's happened today just to see these fireworks.
Well, it's terrific. Now, you've been here all day. What are some of the other activities you've been doing?
Well, there's face painting, there's wrestling. There was a next level wrestling event down at Calhoun's, which was amazing. That was actually a pilot for a television show. There's been all sorts of balloons and activities. There's been concerts on the Q93.1 stage down by Calhoun's as well. It just grows and gets bigger every year.
Well, here's to 25 years of success. Thanks so much for
Thank
being
you.
With us. And now we go back to John and Robin. It's getting really close now, guys. Oh, we're going to break. We'll be right back.
Welcome to the largest Labor Day weekend fireworks show in the nation. My name is Kim Bubkus, the president of Visit Knoxville, and on behalf of our entire organization, welcome to the 25th anniversary of Boomsday. Visit Knoxville is honored to partner with many, as together we are committed to making Boomsday a success each year. Now it's my pleasure to introduce our honorable mayor of Knoxville, Madeline Rojero.
Thank you, Kim. I want to thank all of you on behalf of the City of Knoxville for coming out for this year's Boomsday Festival. Over the past 25 years, Boomsday has become an exciting tradition for our entire region. And this event doesn't happen by itself. A lot of folks work hard to make this event successful, and we appreciate what they do. I've also been asked to remind all the voters that as long as you can see a blue light, you are in a no-wait zone. Now, please join in as we count down to the start of the largest Labor Day fireworks show in the nation. Ready? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, and New York to L.A. Well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, and I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free.
This is head football coach Derek Dooley, and it's football time in Tennessee.
Happy 25th anniversary to Boomsday.
Boomsday 2012, said and done. thousands of lights in the sky and a lot of rain.
Yeah, it started about midway through, and for the people here, they're going to come home and look like they've been in a shower because it has just been pouring for about 15 minutes. So those of you who chose to stick with us and stay at home might have made a decent decision this year.
But what a great show. What was your favorite?
I love the surprise waterfall at the end. To see that go off, we knew something was coming, and I think that I heard a roar when that went up.
Yeah,
how about you?
No doubt. I love the smiley faces and the hearts. That's yes. always.
I saw you tweet about that. Yeah.
There's love in the sky. There's love in the air.
Well, as folks head home, please remember patience if you are listening on the radio, because that's going to be especially important given the weather.
That's right. But we are so appreciative of you joining us. Hope you enjoyed Boomsday 2012. Have a great night, everyone, and a happy Labor Day.
We'll see you next year.
Sell-off. The new Lenoir City Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Gotta make room for the 13s new 2012 Journey. Third row seating. 18.9. Credit off. We help get you on track. The new Lenoir City Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Drive LenoirCity.com.
I never realized how much my smile was affecting my income. I'm a waitress, and my teeth were so bad, I used to cover my mouth. I would never smile. But you can't get good tips that way. Aspen Dental showed me a payment plan that even I could afford.
Right now, get payments as low as $25 per month. And new patients get an exam and x-rays for $19. That's a savings of $161. Call 1-800-ASPEN-DENTAL.